The vice president will be sitting right behind the president tomorrow when Mr. Obama delivers his State of the Union address. And if there are any surprises, well, that'll be a surprise, because the White House has taken the unusual step of rolling out the president's ideas in advance. Here's Chief White House correspondent Major Garrett.
Over the weekend, the White House proposed $320 billion in new taxes, achieved by raising the tax rate on investments for the top 1% of earners and closing inheritance loopholes for the wealthy. The White House says the new tax revenue would pay for all of the president's new spending plans, among them free tuition for community college students who maintain a 2.5 grade point average. Total cost, $60 billion.
The doors of higher education shouldn't be a Democratic issue or a Republican issue. This is an American issue.
In the run-up to tomorrow's speech, the president has called for 6 weeks of paid family leave for federal workers, reductions to federal mortgage insurance fees, new subsidies for rural broadband access, and a new push for consumer cybersecurity protections.
If we're going to be connected, then we need to be protected. As Americans, we shouldn't have to forfeit our basic privacy when we go online to do our business.
Top Republicans who now run Congress have branded the tax plan dead on arrival. Florida Senator Marco Rubio.
The notion, first of all, that in order for some people to do better, someone has to do worse, is just not true. Raising taxes on people that are successful is not going to make people that are struggling more successful.
The White House unveiled these proposals in hopes of overshadowing the new Republican Congress and conveying some sense of policy and political momentum. Scott, Republicans say they're still waiting for what they describe as serious ideas and signs of cooperation from the White House on trade, tax reform, and energy.
Major Garrett at the White House tonight. Thank you, Major.